Powerwall 3 can be installed in groups of up to 4 units. When installing multiple units, they are mounted side by side and require adequate working clearance around each unit. Tesla recommends additional space for ease of installation. Each Powerwall 3 has its own independent circuit connected to a dedicated breaker. These breakers can be either in Gateway's internal panel board or a backed-up load center. Solar input should be evenly distributed to each Powerwall 3. For example, this 18-kilowatt system could be split into 2 9-kilowatt systems or 3 6-kilowatt systems. One Powerwall 3 will be connected to backup switch or gateway with a 4-wire communication cable. It will function as the leader Powerwall 3. All additional Powerwall 3 units are designated as followers. Connect the leader and follower units by daisy-chaining Cat 5 or higher cable into the Ethernet ports on the Tesla asset controller, also known as the TACO. The Ethernet cable can be connected to either port on the TACO. Run Ethernet cable until each Powerwall 3 is connected in this daisy-chain circuit. When installing a system shutdown switch, each Powerwall 3 will have an independent 2-wire circuit run to that switch and terminated on the RSD ports on the TACO. Do not connect multiple RSD circuits to a single terminal block. Instead, use a switch that can control multiple terminal blocks. When all wiring is complete, turn on the breaker and enable switch for each Powerwall 3 in preparation for commissioning. On any of the follower units, wait for this LED to turn light blue on the TACO, then connect to that follower Powerwall 3 in the Tesla One app. On the landing page, ensure that the system is stopped. Tap on the networking tile and configure a connection to the customer's Wi-Fi network. Next, tap on the software tile and confirm the software is updated to version 23.44.1 or later. Wait for the follower Powerwall 3 to reboot. A successful reboot is indicated by this LED turning light blue on the TACO. Exit device setup and repeat this process for any additional follower units. Next, connect to the leader Powerwall 3 with Tesla One. On the landing page, ensure that the system is stopped. Repeat the same steps to connect Powerwall 3 to Wi-Fi and perform a software update. Next, navigate to the system tile and scroll to the bottom of the devices page. Select Scan for Devices. Confirm that all follower units appear on this page before proceeding. A green checkmark indicates that the equipment has successfully paired. A red exclamation mark indicates that pairing was not successful. If a follower Powerwall 3 does not appear in this list, ensure that the breaker and enable switch for each Powerwall is on, then retry scanning for devices. If the follower Powerwall 3 is still not listed, test any field-made Ethernet connections to check for faulty terminations. Tesla recommends factory-made Ethernet cables rather than field-crimped cables whenever possible to reduce the possibility of incorrectly crimped custom cables. If a follower unit still fails to pair, refer to the Powerwall 3 device setup and installation troubleshooting guide for additional support. With all the units paired, return to the landing page and select Start System. Wait for all device firmware updates to complete. The progress of any updates can be viewed in the Devices page. Confirm that there are no alerts and that Powerwall 3 is charging or discharging as expected. The next step is to perform a backup test. Continue with the standard commissioning process to register the equipment to the customer's Tesla app.